Hello, and merhaba arkadaşlar. Teşekkür ederim for having me on the show. The first question that we have is it ethical to use neuroscience methods in marketing? To understand the ethical aspect of applying neuroscience in marketing, or as we call it, neuromarketing, which has already started to replace the traditional marketing models, we must first understand what neuroscience is. To put it absolutely bluntly, neuroscience is the science of understanding human nature. And when I say understand, I actually mean literally looking inside the mind of a person to observe his or her deepest emotions, beliefs, desires, knacks, opinions, and so on. So it is the key to the secrets of every human mind on earth. Naturally, there comes the ethical question. If we have the power to observe a person's emotions and desires, should we abuse that power to manipulate human behavior in society? And the answer is, it is already happening, like it or not. Like in political campaigns, advertising. Advertising firms are now hiring teams of neuroscientists and psychologists to look inside the mind of the consumer. We call this consumer neuroscience. And this actually is helping companies to save a great deal of money. For example, we can record the bodily and brain responses of a bunch of volunteers while showing them a newly developed advertisement of a product. And if the results show that the ad has a positive impact on the viewer's mental activities, then the company can release the ad to the public, or they can choose to modify it if necessary. This is called consumer neuroscience, where we observe the brain activities of the consumers to predict the impact of a product or an advertisement. And the beauty of it is, here we do not need to ask the consumer to tell us how they feel. We can look inside the brain to see how they're feeling in real time, which is much more accurate and economically beneficial for the company. So this is a great power, and perhaps the greatest of all powers, because it literally enables a scientist to observe and manipulate human behavior in society, if we want, that is. So in the end, it comes down to individual responsibility. The responsibility of the individual scientist, or the responsibility of the company hiring those scientists. For example, I myself act as a consultant to several companies, but I choose to help only those companies whose products I find to be beneficial for the society. It is all about the responsibility of humans as social creatures. And that leads me to your next question, which is, are findings in neuroscience research affecting science of sociology? Actually, they have started to do that for a long time now. Today, neuroscience is influencing every single field that has to do with humans, with human life, with human nature. Brain scan data from various neuroscientific experiments are helping researchers in other fields such as social sciences, political sciences, legal sciences, economics, and so on, to develop more robust and effective methods to understand and predict human behavior in the society. We are now witnessing the rise of various new interdisciplinary fields such as neuromarketing, neuropolitics, neurolaw, neurotheology, and so on. And it is bound to get more and more fascinating, because no researcher can ignore the direct access that neuroscience gives us into the human mind. And here comes the next question, which is, can we monitor some kind of evolution of human brain? The evolution of the brain, which means the evolution of the mind, can only be observed if we gather data from neuroscience and psychology research conducted over the decades. So, Evet, yes, we can observe the evolution, that is, the direction in which the collective psyche of the society is moving. For example, research is showing that with the rise of social media, depression and anxiety and other mental health issues are getting intense, especially among the young population. So neuroscience gives us the evidence that this is happening, but what to do with that evidence is completely up to us. Are we going to keep on using social media recklessly, or are we going to develop a kind of self-regulation and use it with moderation? And that's where the responsibility of popular public figures comes in, such as the science communicators, futurists, entertainers, and so on, which reminds me of your next question, which is, what are the neuroscience methods to work with futurists? Here, futurists alone won't change anything. We need all hands on deck, not just so-called futurists. We need every responsible public figure to advocate for a better and healthier future. Every insight that we gain into the human mind, we are sharing it. We scientists are sharing it with everybody through publications, discussions, collaborations. So anybody who feels responsible for the future of humanity must come forward and work with us. As I have said in one of my works, one doesn't need to be a scientist or a philosopher or a politician to solve human problems. Being human is enough. Insano makithai. The direction in which we are moving is not a healthy one, I'm afraid, especially as far as technology is concerned. More and more tech companies who only care about financial gain will utilize or try to utilize neurotechnology to manipulate human behavior in order to make more money. And the result will be a psychologically messed up species that won't even have a minute of peace in their life because their mind will be completely dependent on their technology. It will be like Jahannam on Earth. So you must remember, technology will destroy this planet mentally if responsible individuals do not come forward to advocate for responsible use of technology. And this is not a possibility anymore. It's actually happening right now through social media. Social media has already gained access, huge access, to the psyche of the society, which you called control of society in your next question, which is control of society possible? What if neuroscience methods are used for manipulation? What are the risks if methods are used in a bad way? Control of society. It's already happening right now, and most effectively through social media. You think you are in control, right? You are in control of your behavior. Okay? So do this experiment on your own. The next time you hear a notification on your phone, remember not to pick up the phone. Most people today can't help but pick up their phone every time there is a notification, because social media algorithms are observing your online activity to predict and manipulate your behavior as well as your mood. So basically, you are under the control of these platforms. And the more you use them recklessly without giving a single thought to their negative implications on your mental health, the more you will lose control of your own emotions, of your own behavioral choices. But we still have time. The question is, what are we going to do about it? Start with this. Turn off all the notifications on your phone except the most important ones and check your social media only once or twice a day, not every minute. If you can do this, then perhaps there is a possibility that society will not completely lose control of itself after all. And now comes the next question, which is, as we know more about the human brain, are we figuring out that it's simpler than we thought, or just the opposite? The first and foremost insight that we have gained through research in neuroscience and psychology is that human behavior is hugely driven by subconscious instincts. So your conscious mind is only the tip of the iceberg, and most of your emotional as well as rational calculations are happening beneath the surface of your conscious awareness. So it's a vastly complicated world of electrical impulses. And the more we explore, the more fascinating it becomes to us. And this leads me to your next and final question, I think, which is, will everything lose its meaning when we learn everything about the human brain? Here, the opposite is true. The more we learn about the human brain, the more we learn about ourselves. And the more we learn about ourselves, the more meaning we will have in our life.